A plan to wipe some Cleveland neighborhoods off the map is drawing criticism tonight. About a dozen neighborhoods could be affected. News Channel 5's Tracy Carlos joins us live outside our studios in Midtown. And Tracy, residents take a lot of pride in their close-knit neighborhoods.
Yeah, Danita, they sure do. And now this map, this statistical map that the city uses for statistical purposes, it could change the place that people call home. Veronica Darby Nekvinda loves her Cleveland neighborhood. She's lived here in Cam's Corners for 15 years.
I've raised two children here. I own a couple of businesses here, and very active in the community.
Now the neighborhood she loves so much could have a new name on the map. There is some talk that Cam's Corners could become West Park on the city's statistical planning area map.
West Park has its place, but there's enough room for Cam's also.
Cam's Corners is one of several city neighborhoods whose names could change on the SPA map. So what exactly is it? Well, it's a map that Cleveland uses to keep track of data like population, income, and employment. Steve Lorenz is executive director of the Cam's Corners Development Association, and he says there is no need to panic.
We're a long way from having this be a done deal, too. There's ongoing discussions. People in the Stockyards neighborhood who are concerned about losing that name, I understand that, and I think that's a pretty important thing to them. The Cam's Corners name is always going to be here.
That's because Cam's Corners is at the corner of Rocky River Drive and Lorraine Avenue. But some of the small Cleveland neighborhoods with deep ethnic roots may not be so lucky. Some of the names will stay the same, but some will probably not. Bob Brown is the city's planning director, and he says it's been years since the maps have been updated, and it is time to redraw some boundaries. The new map could also influence ward lines when council shrinks in 2 years.
The SPA boundaries could play a part in determining new ward boundaries, because there is always an attempt to make ward boundaries as logical as can be with respect to neighborhood boundaries, so they can play a part.
Now, the city is in the process of gathering information from council representatives and as well as neighborhood representatives to take it all in before making a decision. That decision is expected sometime before fall. Live in Cleveland, Tracy Carlos, News Channel 5.